Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. On behalf of the HPTN 083 study team, I want to thank the AIDS 2020 Conference Committee for the opportunity to present these results. I also want to thank to all co-authors listed here. These are my disclosures. Despite major advances in treatment and prevention, the HIV pandemic continues to pose a major global health challenge. The HIV epidemic disproportionately affects key populations in the different countries and locations. These populations are usually underrepresented in HIV prevention trials. In previous PrEP studies, challenges with adherence to daily oral tablets have been observed in these populations. Not coincidentally, these are the same populations most affected by HIV. The HPTN-083 is an ongoing phase 2b/3 randomized multicenter double-blind double-dummy clinical trial evaluating the safety and efficacy of a PrEP regimen containing long-acting injectable cabotegravir compared to daily oral TDF-FTC to prevent the sexual acquisition of HIV in cisgender men who have sex with men and transgender women who are at increased risk of HIV infection. In HPTN-083, study participants were randomized in a 1-to-1 ratio to one of two study arms. One arm provided active cabotegravir and a Truvada placebo. The other arm provided active Truvada and placebos for cabotegravir. Cabotegravir was administered daily by mouth for 5 weeks and then via intramuscular injection at 8 weeks intervals and after an initial 4-week interval load. Participants in both arms were then offered open-label daily Truvada for 48 weeks after their final injections. Enrollment was pre-specified to include at least 50% participants under age 30, 10% transgender women, and 50% Black in the United States. The blinded portion of the trial was discontinued at a pre-planned interim DSMB review on May 14, 2020. The primary results of this analysis have been presented at this conference and demonstrated statistical superiority of CAB compared to TDF-FTC. In this analysis, we aimed to describe the pre-specified key subpopulations enrolled in HPTN-083 and the HIV incidence and efficacy of CABLA versus TDF-FTC in these subpopulations. A total of 4,570 HIV uninfected participants were enrolled between December 19, 2016 and March 16, 2020 at 43 sites in Africa, Asia, and North and South America. Overall, the median age was 26, almost 70% of participants were younger than 30 years, and 12.4% were transgender women. Of note, 50% of the participants enrolled in the U.S. were Black African Americans. Latin America, with sites in Argentina, Brazil, and Peru, enrolled the largest number of participants by region. Of note, the median age of participants from South Africa was 23, with 75% of participants younger than 30 years of age and 10% transgender women. In Asia, the Thailand and Vietnam sites in Thailand and Vietnam also enrolled a young cohort of participants and contributed to the largest number of transgender women enrolled on the study. As previously noted, 50% of enrollment in the U.S. was Black African Americans. As you can see in this slide, retention at 12 months in the U.S. was similar between Black African Americans and non-Black. Again, it's important to highlight that 70% of enrolled participants were younger than 30 years of age. Of note, the burden of rectal STIs was higher among the younger participants. Retention at 12 months was higher among those older than 30. Overall, transgender were younger and predominantly enrolled in Asian and Latin American countries. Retention at 12 months was similar regardless of gender identity or sexual orientation. The burden of rectal STIs among trans women was also quite high. As seen in this plot, cabotegravir provided high levels of protection among U.S. Black, transgender, and young MSM globally, consistent with overall study results. Although no statistical inferences can be drawn, the directional and general magnitude of effect is preserved in all subpopulations. Overall, 52 incident HIV infections were observed, 85% of them among participants who were less than 30 years of age. In an adherent subset of approximately 400 randomly selected TDF-FTC participants, 70% had tenofovir diphosphate concentrations consistent with high levels of rectal HIV protection. Lower proportions of participants with protective levels were observed among Black, African American, transgender women, and among those participants enrolled in Latin America. A major accomplishment to be highlighted in HPTN-083 was the extraordinary community engagement and community education work that led to the enrollment and retention of these highly vulnerable populations. In the following slides, you can see pictures from sites in the different regions showing some of the activities performed. In conclusion, HPTN-083 is the first study demonstrating efficacy for an injectable long-acting PrEP agent. Pre-specified subpopulations historically underrepresented in PrEP registrational trials were successfully enrolled, fostering inclusion and equity in scientific development. CAB provided high levels of protection among U.S. Black, transgender, and young MSM globally, consistent with overall study results. Although the trends are in line with overall results, no statistical inferences can be drawn. Lastly, I would like to take the opportunity to thank the community, the study participants and team members, our research sponsors and partners, and our DAIDS NIH, VIV and Gilead colleagues for their participation and support that led to the success of this trial. From the initial study concept to the execution of the trial, the commitment and dedication from these groups have been nothing short of exceptional. Though through the inspirational efforts of our community engagement and educational teams, this landmark study was able to successfully enroll at-risk MSM and transgender women globally, our most underserved populations. Thank you very much.